Hello, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools you can't afford to miss. And you may have noticed by the backdrop over here, I'm actually not in my home studio, but I'm in Doha in Qatar right now. What's really interesting is that I was posting an update recently on social media, and I came to realize that the first AI tool I'm going to tell you about can actually do it for me automatically and may completely remove me and you as a content creator from the loop entirely. This is totally crazy. So the social network butterflies, which I did feature in a previous video, you'll see it on your screen and also down below in the notes on my description for this video. This was launched, well, a couple of months ago by a former Snap engineer. So definitely someone who knows what they're talking about. And many of you gave me feedback saying, well, this just creates AI avatars with random AI postings. What's the use in this? Well, they just recently dropped a new update which allows you to clone yourself. Yeah, let me show you some of the funny snips that I went through. I went and set this up. You have to take a selfie of yourself. It's pretty much very similar to Meta's clone yourself, but obviously that's not available worldwide, whereas Butterfly's AI is available worldwide, and you can just take a few snaps of your face and be instantly cloned. Now, you can give it some direction. I said I'm into cycling and technology. I've got a family, and I also like trance music. And it came up with some pretty wild suggestions about who I could be and how exactly it was going to describe me. It was absolutely insane. So once I had it all dialed in and it gave me the opportunity to choose a profile photo and some other characteristics of what my AI clone would be like, it went ahead and created a profile for me. Now, this is really interesting because the first post it made was quite flattering, actually. It gave me a very muscly look in a nice tight cycling jersey and talked about the fact that I was going to cycle 500 miles from San Francisco to Burning Man in the middle of the Nevada desert. Maybe that is an inner dream of mine that I never really realized. What's more with these AI clones is you can actually prompt them to talk about stuff that you're doing in real life. So if you're a bit shy of oversharing on social media in real life, you can get your AI clone to do it for you. Now, since I've been out here in Doha, I had to do one thing, and that's try the Olympic cycling track. It's the world's longest continuous cycle path, apparently, and I did post photos to real social media, but I also thought my AI clone could share this story too. I prompted it, and it came up with an epic post with the Doha skyline behind me and what looked like a pretty convincing cycle path. So, for those of you who want to create an AI clone and share stuff about your life but not be too personal or share real photos, this could well be for you. It's called Butterflies AI. It's been around for a while now. I created some other avatars when I first set it up, and they've gone off and done wild things, such as in one scenario getting lost in an abandoned warehouse. A little bit weird if you ask me. But anyway, go and check it out. The link will be down in the description to go and test Butterflies for yourself and maybe clone yourself and go ahead and share some of your results in the comments. I really would like to hear about them. By the way, if you're really enjoying this video, then do throw a like and also subscribe to my channel as I'm doing these videos weekly to bring you up to date with all the AI tools. Next up, we're going to explore the new releases from Google in the AI world. Now, they were teasing Image Gen 3 for a while, and again, I've mentioned that in a previous video, but the most interesting release from Google in their Gemini Advanced update this week is the ability to create gems. What I think are really cool about gems, consider them like a kind of ChatGPT, custom GPT, but on steroids and with all the power of Google. So as you'll see here, you can experience Google's most capable AI for free for the first month. It's running on Gemini 1.5 Pro right now. And as you can see, the new stuff here includes the ability to build custom AI experts with gems and the power of Google, of course. You can also go live with Gemini. You might have seen in their Pixel reveal recently. You can have real-time live conversations with Gemini, kind of like the advanced mode of ChatGPT's voice that we've been waiting for ages, but it's launched and live inside Gemini. So let's go ahead and try this out. Okay, looks like we're in with access to 1.5 Pro, priority access to new features, and also a 1 million token context window. Now that's a big deal. You can feed in tons of information in one prompt to Gemini and get results. It's also including stuff like Gmail docs and more. 2 terabytes of storage, and of course all the stuff you'd expect with Google One perks. But I'm here to test out Gemini Advanced Gems, and you can see the gems are available by this little icon over here. You can then go ahead and create your own gems. Now, of course, there's pre-made stuff from Google like Brainstormer, Career Guide, Coding Partner, Learning Coach. You can also discover stuff as well, kind of like the GPT store, but everything is here and ready to use. I'm going to go ahead and create a new basic gem, and I'm going to give it a name. Now, I am going to base this gem on actually a prompting library I really like. It's available on GitHub, and it's by a chap called Daniel Missler. It's called Fabric, and basically, Daniel has identified how to make really cool prompts. And this extract wisdom prompt I use all the time to get information and summaries from stuff that I'm trying to research. So there are a lot of steps in this prompt. I'm not going to use the whole prompt, but I am going to use this very specific part of it, extract a summary of the content in 25 words, including who is presenting and the content being discussed, into a section called summary. Okay, I'm going to copy that and paste it into the instructions here. But I'm going to be very specific. So put a little prefix to my prompt. When you are given a YouTube link by the user, you will always use, and then you can at tag different Google products. So I'm going to go at, and here they all are. And I'm going to choose YouTube. Now, obviously, I need to give it a name, so I'll call it Extract YouTube Wisdom. Okay, now that's all done. It should give me a little preview of my gem. And look, I can actually test out my gem with the prompt and see how it works below. So let's give it a go. Now, luckily, I came prepared, and I've got the video I released last week all about coding with Cursor Compose. It's a pretty cool video that I recommend you check out if you want to build anything with code, not even having to need to know code. But let's see if Extract YouTube Wisdom cracks this. So I'll copy the YouTube link, and I'm just going to paste it as my prompt. That's all I'm going to do, and see what my Extract YouTube Wisdom gem does for me. Okay, and there it is, the title summary, just as I asked. This video is about an AI tool called Cursor Composer that allows you to create apps without any coding knowledge. Excellent. The video goes through. So this is absolutely spot on and very relevant. It even mentions the other AI tools like Photo AI and Ideogram that were mentioned, so it didn't miss anything out. It gives me a nice link if I want to then click through and watch more of the video. And I can actually see myself using gems just like this in the future to summarize videos, because I haven't got a lot of time to go through all of my favorite creators. But now with a gem like this, I could quickly summarize stuff and get the lowdown. So I'm actually going to go ahead and save this gem, and then I'll be able to use it in the future. I can click Start a Chat right here, and look at this. Now I have Extract YouTube Wisdom, and I can put any YouTube video in there I like. Maybe I could go ahead and copy a YouTube link from one of my favorite YouTubers, Mr. Who's the Boss, and find out the pointless tech that he bought on the internet. I wonder how well Extract Wisdom will summarize that video. I'm guessing he's featured quite a lot of pointless tech. Let's paste it in and see what my gem does. And there we go. It's about useless tech products that the host, Mr. Who's the Boss, bought on the internet to find out if they're as useless as they look. He reviews products including a spoon that vibrates when you eat too fast, a jacket with air conditioning unit inside, a phone case that runs Android. He also tests out the most expensive product, a $1,400 pair of shoes designed to make you walk faster. Now, immediately reading that Extract YouTube Wisdom summary, I am very tempted to now click through and watch his full video. How cool is that? Got to say, I'm pretty impressed with gems from Google's Gemini Advanced. Give me an API, Google, and we'll be best friends. So there you go, gems from Google, kind of like GPTs, but with all the power of Google running in the background. And if you've never tried Gemini Advanced before, you'll most likely get a 1-month free trial that you can sign up to on their website. And I'll link that down in the description below. And finally, let's move on to Playground. This is a really interesting tool for creative content creators just like you and me. And I wanted to dive in and have a little play with Playground to show you some of the potential. So here's the premise. Design anything like a pro, and you can download an iOS app as well. Now, the pricing, first and foremost, is actually free to get started with. And then Pro Design starts from just $12 a month. Now, the idea with this is you can prompt change stuff in the image and make it really cool. So I might change the text, and I'll say change the text to awesome bike ride. Click create. Boom, looking really cool. Now I want to go ahead and change something else. Let's click what if it were. And let's change this scene to a long, never-ending bike path with the Doha city skyline in the background. Boom, and there you go. It looks like I'm cycling across a sandy precipice there into the Doha city lights. Very nice indeed for a first attempt. Let's create something else. This time I'm going to test logo, because we all need good logos. Let's choose digital art as inspiration, and whoa, I quite like the look of that otter. And there you go, that is one friendly oryx there waving as a potential logo that I can use in the future. So there you go, that's Playground, another new AI tool that seems to give you a lot of creative freedom in the kind of stuff you're designing, and it seems to be geared to people who want to create t-shirts, posters, stickers, and creative posts for social media. I think it's going to be a really interesting tool, and I'm going to be playing with this a little bit more in the coming weeks. And of course, the link will be down below, just like all the other tools and news that I've mentioned in this video. I really hope you're enjoying these weekly updates, and if you are, do throw a like and subscribe, because every single week you can watch an update like this. And if you can't get enough and you want to go down the rabbit hole and see more AI tools I've been playing with recently, click the playlist that's showing somewhere on your screen now, because you'll be able to watch all the weekly updates on the AI tools I find right here on Creator Magic. Thanks for watching.